So how big is it? Classic question, the first question of all statistical analysis, and it turns out it can be useful if you can answer this. So, this is a tank. Not just any tank, that's a Panzer. The Panzer was the biggest, toughest tank in the world when it was produced, and that was unfortunate because it was a Nazi tank. The Americans, the British, the Allied forces had nothing that could go up against this Panzer one-on-one. We had to outnumber them, which meant we needed to know how many of them there were. And actually, this is a classic question from the history of warfare. How many of your enemy forces do you have? So, how many Panzers are there? How many are being produced in any given month? We needed to know this, and how are we gonna figure it out? Well, spies. Okay. You take people and you get them behind enemy lines. And during the day, they're working in, you know, the grocery store, and they're stacking groceries and speaking the best German they know how. And then at night, they are in the back of their apartment with a pair of binoculars, and they're watching the factory, the road in front of the factory. And what they're doing is counting trucks. Trucks of iron ore going into the factory, because so much iron ore becomes so much steel, and so much steel becomes so many Panzer tanks. So, iron ore, steel, now I know how many tanks there are, because I'm a spy. It's very dangerous work that they're doing. And then back in England, there was a group of statisticians hanging out in the pub. You need to know how many Panzers there are? And they're like, yes, actually we do. Well, the Germans are really orderly, right? Oh yeah, they are. They put serial numbers on the tanks, right? And the serial numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, that's right. Oh, could you just bring us the numbers of any tanks you happen to capture or kill? Don't you want to see the tank parts? No, really, the numbers will be plenty. And so what the statisticians did, they took the numbers of any tanks that were captured or killed and they lined them up like this. And they said, well, I know that there's a tank one out there someplace. So if I take the differences, I start getting, there's a difference of, you know, between 1 and 6, there's 5, and then there's 5 and 11 and 7. And on average, the mean difference in the tanks, the mean number of tanks, the average number of tanks that we're not seeing is 6.8. I'm gonna round up and call it 7. And since the highest number I saw was 35, that means there were 42 tanks. There, 42 tanks, there's your answer. At the same time, the spies were coming up with some very different numbers, so let's look at those. Okay, here we have the estimates from the spies for 3 representative months. 1,000, 1,550, 1,550. Here we have the estimates from the statisticians back at the pub. The numbers are considerably smaller. Who do we trust? Well, hard to know. Except at the end of the war, we captured the factory and we got the actual records of tank production. This is what those look like. Yeah, the statisticians got it right. Not only did the statisticians have estimates of numbers of tanks that were much closer to reality, but if you'll notice between, you know, those 2 later periods, there was actually a considerable increase in tank production, and the statisticians caught it and the spies missed it. If you're a spy and you're counting iron ore, maybe you got the right number of trucks for the iron ore, but you missed the trucks of rubber for the tank treads, and they just didn't have very many tank treads, so they couldn't finish making the tanks. Or maybe they had the rubber for the tank treads, but they didn't have the copper wire for the navigation systems. The point was that statisticians got it right, because statisticians are, or can be, the greatest spies in the history of the world. Because we can answer that question of how big is it?